times that we make beautiful fashion balls in Harlem and we compete. One would compete for face and the other one would compete for body and the other one would compete for the best wardrobe. And you're waiting and your heart starts to pound and says, am I going to get another trophy? Or am I getting too old?
Give me the grand prize money and leave me here with you for you to beat me if I don't start. So I'm starting. And all those children that haven't made it, I'm sorry. Would you give me a little respect so you can hear people's names and you'll know why they're on the judges' panel? Excuse me, one and all.
Started it now?
Well, I wouldn't be able to tell you who started it, but I know it started back in the 50s because I was little and they used to have balls on 155th Street and 8th Avenue at a ballroom where only a small minority of people would go once a year. And they would have a ball for all the gay kids in the city that would come.
Wasn't permitted to walk down the street in girls' clothes, and
it should be seven.
If the police would catch you wearing girls' clothes, would throw you in jail for 60 days alone. And they used to invade parties that we used to have together with the boys, and birthday parties we used to dream of, and get all dolled up just for the party. For that weekend, or the Sunday, the cops used to come and everybody in the paddy wagon, and it used to be a nightmare, but then it was fun at the time.
And then it graduated, like they had one out in Long Island, where up in Harlem on 155th Street, I mean, there was like the blacks and the Spanish would go to Rockland Palace. And then out on Fire, and Daisy D, which was a big white queen, had the ball for the white queens out in, way out in Long Island.
So when...
It went from being a downtown big ball, where there was only like three or four a year, then it went uptown and diversified out to become a much more multi-category ball.
What it is...
I'm dressing, of course, to go to a show because I've always done this professionally. And I was a dancer. And I'm trying to remember when the first time I went to a ball that was the early type ball, when everybody just walked and they gave away like four or five prizes in a very limited category. And the children now, most of them, 75% of them of the children you see at the ball, wouldn't know what a ball was if it knocked them in the head. a sense, so am I. But a very much different quantity. No magazine's gonna run up to cover me if I go to a premiere. But it's still a fame. It's a small fame. But you absorb it, you take it. And you like it. You like the adulation, the applause, the people cheering you on, the winning. It's like a physical high. It's an addictive high, like all highs in the long run turn out to be. But it's a high that won't hurt you. If everybody went to balls and did less drugs, it'd be a fun world, wouldn't it?
I first started going to balls, it was all about drag queens, and they were interested in looking like Las Vegas showgirls. Back pieces, tail pieces, feathers, beads, and all that. But as the 70s rolled around, the things started changing. It started coming down to just one that looked like a gorgeous movie star like Marilyn Monroe or Elizabeth Taylor.
I grew up, you want to look like Marlon the teacher, Betty Grable. Fortunately, I didn't know that I really wanted to look like Lena Horne. Nobody wanted to look like Lena Horne. Everybody wanted to look like Marilyn Monroe.
Here's our fourth runner-up, Miss Alfonso from Chicago. Let's hear it for her, ladies and gentlemen. Our third runner-up in the 1967 Nationals from Manhattan, Miss Crystal, ladies and gentlemen. Let's hear it for her, the third runner-up in the 1967 Nationals. Okay, now we're down to the real nitty-gritty.
You think she deserved
Darling,
it?
She didn't deserve
Answer
nothing.
Answer me. You're not speaking from the damn camera. You have a mind. Do you think
Prince,
she deserves it?
It's only publicity, and it's bad publicity for Holland and all the rest, because I'm declared as one of
the judges didn't have any
world.
Taste. It was with you that the judges was with, darling.
Because it's over. Get a picture with me and Harlow and we'll see which is more beautiful,
because
darling.
Because she knew it's Victor Harlow. She said, Crystal, darling, don't go.
That's right,
because you're not going to get it. And that's why all the true beauties didn't come.
You. It's in bad taste, and you're showing your colors and stuff.
I am doing it bad, but I have a right to show my color, darling. I am beautiful, and I know I'm beautiful.
I'll sue the bitch.
Did you sign
I will
release?
No, I didn't sign any release. And if she releases any picture of me, I will sue the fool. She won't make money off of my name, darling. She can make it off of Harlow and all the rest of the fools that will flock to her. But not Crystal, darling. Anybody but her.
Your name is LaBeija.
Pepper LaBeija.
Yes,
it was Crystal LaBeija and Subway LaBeija. At that time, it was only drag queens.
These are your friends that all took your name?
Yeah. I took Crystal's name. Crystal was the mother of the
house. All right, so Crystal LaBeija was someone that went...
To balls. She competed against the white drags.
Right.
Painted white and won over some white queen sometimes.
Okay. So now you said, I'm a friend of Crystal, so I'm going to be called part of the house of LaBeija.
What's in the 70s, my house was the first house to start it. they were basically like clubs like the Dupree's and La Chanel's.
These are clubs, gay clubs.
LaBeija became a house. We started calling ourselves houses after the fashion houses. But LaBeija not being a fashion house, we were the first one to say we were a house. And then everybody started tagging on saying they were a house.
Now, before we go into this category, I want to let the girls, the girls that like me and things, know. For grand prize, the girls can walk too. So you all better be ready, because if they decide to, there's a few that can really serve you.
It's a work of art, really, to look beautiful. It takes a lot. It takes patience. It takes time. To the bathroom and just put it on for a couple of minutes and then take it off and put it back. So I dressed up like a girl. I liked it. I said, oh, I enjoy myself more than ever. So therefore I the illusion was beginning to create in my mind that I could do so much better as a girl for myself.
There she is. She's out there. You can give her a round of applause. Most of you wouldn't dare.
You always know who you are, what you are, and what you're going to do.
Thank you, darling.
We have times that we make beautiful fashion balls in Harlem, and we compete once one would compete for face, and the other one would compete for body, and the other one would compete for the best wardrobe. And you're waiting, and your heart starts to pound. And says, am I going to get another trophy? Or am I getting too old? And all of a sudden, five finalists come up, and you're one of them, and you say, oops, I think I got it. And all of a sudden, and the winner is Miss Sugar for the most beautiful body.
Sugar for body.